Hey everybody, welcome back. We're gonna be playing some more Shenmue today. Hey Chris. So we finally figured out the mystery of the Mad Angels. We have, sort of. And I'll explain as we get into it because I'm actually gonna have to, we're gonna have to get through like another entire day of work, unfortunately, to move the story forward. Basically, what I was missing, was that, there's two paths to take, basically, when you're delivering crates to warehouse number 3. There's the left path and there's the right path. And I was exclusively pretty much using the left path to deliver crates. And what I was missing was that there's actually a cutscene that kicks in if you're taking the right path at a certain time of day. I think it's past 3:30 is what I noticed. Past 3:30, if you're taking the right path, and I think you even need to be holding a crate in your forklift, you'll activate a cutscene, and that I think is what progresses that day forward. So we've basically up until now just kind of been living the same day.
Excuse me? Huh? Do you know anything about the Mad Angels?
About the Mad Angels? I hear it's a gang of foreigners. Ain't too sure though.
Thanks.
All right, so we'll do that. Basically, we've kind of been living the same day over and over. I mean, that's why that one guy was, you know, no matter how many days had passed, he'd been like, oh, like, I heard you helped Mark yesterday. You know what I mean? Even though that happened, like, literally 4 days ago. It's because, yeah, it doesn't actually, like, technically doesn't move the story forward until you've done, you know, that cutscene. So, it took me like 3 hours of messing around offline, which is why I didn't do a stream. I didn't do a Shenmue stream on Friday. I didn't want to just kind of like continue messing around on stream and just, you know, basically just doing the same thing over and over. I wanted to figure out how to like move the story forward. So yeah, I spent about 3 hours trying to figure out like what was it that I was missing. And I got to the point where I was like, oh my gosh, like did I like, you know, am I hitting like a glitch, you know what I mean? Like, because I was looking everywhere. I could not figure out how to progress this, or sorry, how to progress the story. I even, like, I went back to, you know, Dubweed's at the end of the night, and I would, you know, look around the bars and see if there's anything about sailors. So yeah, it was, you know, a little bit of a process to figure out how to get this cutscene to trigger, but I think I have it down now, so we can actually move on with the story. But for now, I kind of just have to wait until tomorrow, because it has to be during the day, like I said, you have to be taking the right path, I think after 3:30, and you have to be holding a crate, and then you'll get the cutscene. Playing Persona 5, can't hear you, but gonna leave you up. Thank you very much, Yui. I know you can't hear me, but I really appreciate it. Thank you for your amazing support. Also, I hope you guys are having a really good day. I know it's Monday, you know what I mean? So I know how it can be sometimes, but hope you guys are doing well. Do we have any songs that we hear that we don't own? No, we have these ones, I think. So yeah, we'll skip that. What I will do though, I'll buy some chocolate. Also, what else was I gonna say? There was something else I wanted to mention. Now I can't remember. We'll buy some chocolate.
I'll take this.
Yeah, sure. Thank you very much.
I think when me and my dad played it all the way back in the Dreamcast days, we stumbled upon most of the triggers and events by accident. Yeah,
sure.
I mean,
sure, draw a raffle ticket.
Oh, nice. We get a raffle. We've been pretty lucky, I think, for this like playthrough in terms of like triggering events.
No win.
Ah, too bad.
Try again another time.
I feel like this is really the first like roadblock we hit where I was just like, how how are we able to get this, you know, cutscene to trigger? How are we able to move forward, you know? So luckily we
I'll take this, please.
You know, we have it figured out.
Yeah,
and I'm
sure.
Hoping that
thank you very much.
We won't run into anything like that again today, you know what I mean? Like once
sure,
we pass that.
Draw a raffle ticket.
But we'll see. Now I know that I have to obviously make sure to take, while I'm working, like, take all the paths, just in case. You know what I mean?
No win.
I'll mix it up as we're delivering
Try
crates.
Try again another time.
Um, All right, so get some dried fish. I'm basically just gonna pack my pockets with snacks. We kind of have to stick around until 8 o'clock.
I'll take this, please.
Yeah, sure. Thank you very much. Please come again.
It does say to the design of the game, despite all its jank, had natural appeals in the list. You just bumble into it. Yeah, it's true. With some slight guidance by your own common sense. That's the thing, like, for the most part, right? You kind of just, like, stumble on things, right? Naturally, just playing the game. That's true. And, you know what was throwing me off, though? Like, one of the things that was really kind of, like, throwing me off was the fact that, Grisang, right? When we went and saw him, he was like, oh, talk to the sailors, right? That was his, like, hint, was basically, like, go talk to the sailors. But there's no sailors. I'm sorry. I went everywhere, okay? That was one of the things. I went everywhere. There's no sailors actually just hanging out, at the moment anyway, like, around the harbor. Basically, like, I even went to, like I said, I went to Dobuita after, and I would, like, you know, check the bars. And no, there's no sailors. But what happens is the cutscene that triggers, right, is with, I think, you know, those sailor guys. So that was, like, I guess, kind of like the hint, right? Was that you're going to be encountering sailors, but you're like, you can't actively kind of, like, look them out. And so I was spending a lot of time trying to, like, figure out, like, where is there sailors? But, like, there is none, right? It's just when the cutscene triggers, it's going to be with, like, what I think is, you know, sailor guys. So yeah. Anywho. Oh, that's another thing. I also found, it was pretty funny, I found a soft lock, when I was doing my testing too. If you have your portable, cassette player open and, like, listening to music, when the game goes from, like evening to night, right? When it does that transition at 7 o'clock, it basically locks the game. You can't, like, first of all, your cassette player stops playing music, okay? But then you can't leave your cassette player. You're just kind of stuck there. like, none of the buttons work, basically. You're just kind of stuck at the cassette player screen. And time keeps moving. It's pretty funny. I think it's just, like, the game doesn't understand how to, like, turn off your cassette player in order to show the cutscene where it, like, transitions from evening to night. And it's, like, it wants to, but it can't, and so it just kind of, like, chokes. Anyway, we can head back at 8 o'clock. I have to wait literally for 8 o'clock, and then we're gonna make a mad dash for the bus. So give me a second and this should be good. We basically have to run to the bus. There we go. Yeah, that's a huge oversight. Yeah, I mean, it's just one of those little things, you know what I mean? And luckily that didn't happen, you know, on stream. Because sometimes I do kind of just, like, pass time listening to the music. So, yeah. But for the most part, yeah, this is, you know, it's been a pretty smooth playthrough so far. Like I said, we'll be able to progress after I've done just a little bit of work tomorrow. In-game. We'll do our crate thing, and then... And also, what's cool, it's Christmas Eve today, so we can talk to Santa.
Excuse me.
Merry Christmas! Ho, ho, ho! Oh, hello there. MJQ Jazz Bar offers a variety of cocktails. You're too young to drink. Sorry, kid.
It's okay.
I can't tell if this is, like, meant to actually be Santa, or if it's just some guy who's, like, being paid to basically wear a Santa suit and promote, like, Dobuita stuff. You know what I mean? It's kind of funny. But yeah. Kind of sucks we have to work on Christmas Day. But it is what it is. shipping schedules wait for no one. It's a good point. Stuff has to keep moving. Okay, so we're gonna save. And we'll move on to the next day. What am I training at the moment? I think I'm training hand moves, right? No, I'm training all moves. No, I'm not. Just to be safe, I'll train hand moves. There we go. And then we'll go to sleep. Alright, so we're going to be starting off with the usual forklift racing, which we already have all the forklifts from getting all the different places and ranks, so this is just for fun now. Although, is it ever really just for fun? Forklift racing is serious business.
Morning! Time for a daily warm-up race. You all do your best now.
Yeah!
Okay, no problem,
like
Chris.
Like always, three laps to the finish. Everybody ready?
Yeah!
On your mark. Almost time to go. Ready? Go!
Oh my gosh, these guys! Oh my god. Honestly, the hardest part of forklift racing is just getting by these guys because they ram you into the walls. Or for that, it would actually wouldn't be too bad. Alright, let's try to get past this guy so we don't have to contend with getting smacked into things. Oh no! I don't know if we're gonna be able to catch up in time. Well, maybe. Maybe if I'm lucky, I can get by him. Gonna have to be taking some really tight turns. That was tight, okay. Almost didn't make it.
Pretty damn good for a rookie. Here's your first place prize.
Thanks.
Hope you work as well as you race.
I'm ready.
Today, you got to take this cargo to warehouse number 3. Here's the map. Don't forget the quota.
No problem.
Okay, good luck.
Okay, so warehouse 3 again. We already knew that. And I'm basically just going to be, like I said, I need to make sure to take the right path. I think past 330 with a crit. So as long as I do that, we should trigger the cutscene. And until then, I'm basically just going to have a regular work day. Because there's not much else going on. Oh my god. People. Why? Why? So basically what I'll try to do is hit quota. So we can get our raise. And then... I won't worry too much about this. Oh my gosh. Let's try to get this in here. There we go.
Mwah.
Yeah, it's funny, because you know what? Taking the left path is pretty hazardous anyway. I think taking the right path is a lot easier. It's a lot more... There's a lot more room. Yeah, so basically, we have to go this way to trigger the cutscene, so... Well, to be fair, you don't really have to go this way, but I think what you have to do is, next to the lunch lady there, you have to be, like, basically over here. And then when you come over here, it triggers a cutscene. So that's what I was missing. Welcome back, Chris. Thank you. Okay, so this might be the last crate before lunchtime. Maybe we'll see. Should I get one more in? No, I don't think we're gonna make it. Oh, maybe. Maybe. I'm really, really quick if I just dump it. Oh, no! Policeman, why? Alright, nice. Okay. So we already got 7 crates, which means in the afternoon we really only have to put 1 crate down to get quota. Easy raise. And then here we'll just... let's drive right over to the lunch area. We'll just park right in front of the lunch station.
Lunchtime, eh?
Alright, so yeah, I always found it weird how this guy, I mentioned this before, but like,
Hitoshi,
this guy here.
Hi, Ryo, isn't it? Yes. I heard you helped out Mark yesterday.
See?
It was nothing.
Every
There's
day.
There's many mean-ass thugs in the harbor. It feels good to know there's someone like you around.
Nah, I'm not that strong.
And I kept wondering, I was like, why does he keep saying yesterday, right? Even though it's been like a week since then. And that's why. It's because basically, it's kind of like a Groundhog Day situation a little bit, if you don't actually, like, see the cutscenes you're meant to see, during, like, that specific workday, then it basically replays the same workday, so. Alright, what I'm gonna do, I'll head over to the lunch area and see if maybe there's some, like, Christmas specials or something, who knows. Let's check it out. Nah, it doesn't really look like it. I mean, I think we bought everything else too, so. Oh well. Maybe we can wish Tom a Merry Christmas. Oh, you know what? The old guy's not here. We can see if maybe he's training. Because he said that sometimes he practices, I think, in the warehouse. We can go check it out and see if he's there. I think it's warehouse number 4 is the training warehouse.
Maybe I can practice here. Think I'll warm up a bit.
No, it doesn't look like he's here. So we'll leave.
Tom.
Hi, Dio!
I've got something to ask you. Do you know anything about the Mad Angels?
Ryo? You in trouble with them?
Nope, I'm just trying to find out about them.
No, man! Do not go and get mixed up with them! They're killers!
Alright, well, I guess there's no extras for Christmas, at least not here. Let's change his music. Hell yeah. Okay. So yeah, we don't really have too much going on then until work starts again, so. Oh yeah, one thing I did want to see, because I think we can sell things, right? I want to see how much those forklift toys go for, because every time I get first place, I get a first place forklift. But I don't need more than one.
Yes? What is it?
Do you know anything-
Hey! What? Don't talk about-
Okay.
I felt like there was some place we could sell things. Am I crazy? Guess it's not here, but... I like how this one is a bit different.
One game, 100 yen.
I'll play it once.
Also, I was taking a look at the trophies, and there's a trophy for getting 25 capsule toys and 50 capsule toys. So I'm going to have to do that at some point, too.
Whoa. No, good.
That was way off.
So close.
To be fair, the high score is only 50, so... It's not too bad.
So close. Last one. I'm getting it. The best. No more darts.
The best.
Maybe next time.
Okay. So work's gonna be starting again. Let's head back outside. That's what I love about Ryo. He's both robotic and like overly enthusiastic at the same time. Okay, so work is going to be starting again in just a second. And then we finally get to, I think, maybe beat up some more thugs. So that'll be interesting.
It's already this late. Warehouse number 3. Okay.
So, all we have to do is make sure, I think, like I said, past 3:30, holding a crate, taking the right path. So, I'll just make sure I'm in the right place at the right time, and we should be able to move everything forward. So I think with that crate too, we hit quota. So we'll be getting our raise. Cut out for a sec? Like the video or the audio? Didn't look like I had dropped anything. Oh, you did, okay. I was like, oh no. Well, welcome back. Okay, well it's almost 3 o'clock, so what I'll do is I will I'll deliver one more crate, and then I will pick up another crate and then just kinda like hang around with it until 3:30. And then that way we can trigger the cutscene. I'm like super paranoid. I don't wanna miss this cutscene again. I wanna move forward. Okay, so from here, I'm literally just gonna hang out here. We'll take a look at our little map here. Why does he open the map upside down? I noticed that too. Oops, we're in this guy's way. When you open the map, it always opens upside down. Even if I try to flip it like right side up, then when you close it and open it again, it's upside down again. You would think that he would, I mean, like it says quota 8 upside down. Funny because when I was trying to figure everything out, I was looking at this too, and I was like, I was like looking at the warehouse numbers, and I was like, have I visited all the warehouses? Like, where could I possibly be missing something? So yeah. All right, let's we'll start making our way over here. And then once it hits 3:30, we should be good. Yeah, so if I go over here now, fingers crossed. There we go.
Hey, look! It's Schoolboy!
You guys.
What the hell are you doing here?
Children shouldn't play around with forklifts. You might get hurt, you know. Ha!
Move it.
You heard us? You're fired. Ha! Ha! Nice taxi you got here. Take me on home, okay? Get a move on.
Whatever.
He just drives him in. Drop his ass into the water, right? Oh, damn. Oh. Oh, there's actually quite a lot of guys in here.
Hey, cut it out! Joke's on you, Schoolboy!
That's it. You're mine.
It's showtime!
Alright, here we go. Alright, that wasn't too bad. Oh, there's two- oh, geez. There's like a whole bunch more guys. Trying to throw him because I just want to try, like, I don't really do any throw moves, right? I just kind of do kicks and punches. Alright, well, these guys are taken care of.
Oh man. Help me!
Where are the Mad Angels?
Those guys are at the back of warehouse number 17.
Number 17?
Yeah, at the back of the warehouse.
You lying?
If you don't believe me, go see for yourself.
All right. I'm just gonna go back to delivering crates. Okay, good. So, progress, and hopefully something happens then when we go to warehouse 17. Let's just try to deliver this crate. There we go. It's funny because you know what? Like, sorry guys. Okay, sorry about that. You know what's funny is that I can take on like 8 guys, no problem. And then there's that one dude that you fight when you're saving the kid with the soccer ball. Was it him? Yeah, I think it was him, right? And he's like ridiculously strong and he takes like a million hits to take out and he does throws and everything. I feel like he's Ryo's true rival in this game. It's not even Guizong. It's just random thug number 3. Oops. Okay, so I think this will be the last crate that we deliver. And then we can... finish up the day, and then I'll go to Warehouse 17 after. Well, let's just chill here. Enjoy the view for a couple seconds.
Yen per crate. That's the best salary in the company.
The best salary in the company.
Thank you.
Keep up the good work.
That's hilarious.
Yes, thank you very much.
If I recall, you're coming up on a part where you gotta fight like a bazillion people. I remember that, and I'm actually really looking forward to that. You do. There's like a part where you have to fight like an insane amount of dudes. Which is actually pretty awesome. And then, what's really, really cool, I know that in the original Dreamcast version, I wonder if they kept it for this one. But in the original Dreamcast version, 1 second, restarting PC, no problem. You can actually unlock after you beat the game. You can unlock the actual fight, and you can redo it as many times as you want. It's kind of like a fun little, like, massive, like, brawl between a whole bunch of enemies, which is actually really cool. Okay, so we're going to... Oh, here we go. Oh, jeez. Oh, no. It's the hard thug.
You again? This time you're dead.
Oh, man. Just as I was talking about that thug, there he is. Yeah, him. The one with the camo jacket. Like, look at that. Look at how much health he has. It's ridiculous. Him and the other guy. They have a lot of health. Okay, let's try to keep our distance. Maybe we can get some health back. Try to get away. Need some health. Oh no. Don't lose the fight. Oh no, this is bad. We died. Can I just, like, run away and try to get health back? Oh. Oh, come on! Okay, let's just take it easy. Oh, there we go. Okay, woof. That was close.
We won't forget this.
Mark, you okay?
Yeah, I'm all right. No problem. Oh.
Careful. So, looking for your brother.
Yeah, he did.
Yeah, my only brother. He's about your age.
Oh.
But now, he's probably at the bottom of the sea.
Oh, that's sad.
Killed by the Mad Angels.
Why would the Mad Angels kill your brother?
It appears he may have leaked some important information.
Is that why they...
Probably. At least as far as I could tell, only one person was killed.
So you're not sure?
Was the guy who heard the information killed, or my brother, the one who leaked it? Oh yeah, Dio. I heard the information was about a black market deal with some Chinese cartel.
A Chinese cartel? The GU men.
Okay. Okay, so the Mad Angels were making a deal with the GU men. If I follow them, they'll lead me to GU men. Alright, well. So let's see now if maybe I can trigger anything else while I'm here. Since I think we're just kind of stuck here for a little while anyway. I might have to wait until tomorrow now. See if the old guy maybe has something more to teach us. He's actually taught us a lot. We've got like, what, 3 moves from him, technically? Which, to be fair, I probably should have tried using some of those. I have all these moves and I just stick to like punching kick.
Excuse me.
Eh? What is it, youngin?
Do you happen to know where the Mad Angels hang out?
Why are you looking for them? I hear you've been getting yourself in all sorts of trouble.
I really need to know where they are. If you know, please tell me.
Already. Come back here at night.
Here?
They always gather around here at night.
Okay, there we go.
At night. I understand. Thank you.
Don't go doing nothing reckless, you hear?
Okay. You know what? Oh, actually, hold on. It's about to be nighttime. Funny enough. I'm gonna save. Because I don't know, like, if I actually die, do I have to, like, load a save file? In which case, I don't want to have to redo the whole day. You know what I mean? So I'm gonna save. Just to be careful. Okay. And then... He said to come back here. It's like, did he mean like here? Or just like generally like the harbor? I heard that bikers gather at night near the harbor cafeteria. Okay, so we will actually go back. I was probably just... Because I was already there, it didn't trigger, so... Might also be... too early, so...
Excuse me? About the location of the Mad Angels?
I don't know any other place.
Alright.
Might have to wait a little bit longer. I'll just keep running around here. I assume it'll be, like, probably after 8, because that's when everyone seems to leave the harbor, basically. So I'll just chill until 8 o'clock comes around.
Yes? Have you seen the Mad Angels?
The Mad Angels? I've never seen them. I've heard that they hang out at warehouse number 17 at night.
Alright.
Okay, well, I've got a little bit of time. Let's go to warehouse 17 just to be safe. Make sure we're not missing anything. And then if nothing triggers over there, then we'll come back here. Okay, no, so nothing's happening here, so we'll go back to the cafeteria area. It should be good now since it's past 8 o'clock. Still nothing.
Excuse me?
Yes? What is it?
I'm just...
Recently, it hasn't been very safe around here. If you don't have any business here, you should leave now.
Have a minute?
What is it?
I heard about this gang in the harbor called the Mad Angels.
I know who you mean.
Do you know anything about them?
Sure. You know those morons on top of that shouting something about how they gotta hurry the deal up and all. I really wish they'd keep it down.
Okay.
Hurry the deal up? For a second, I thought he was going to repeat the exact same thing he's been saying for the past, like, 4 days. I'll give it till 9 o'clock, because if I leave it too late, I'm not gonna be able to get home in time. So,
I should go home.
Okay, let's see if anything happens or... No, it doesn't look like it. Okay, last ditch effort, I'll give it until 9:30. And if nothing triggers after 9:30, then I'll head back and we'll see if some new stuff happens tomorrow instead. Okay, so 9:30, anything? If not, then I'll just have to come back tomorrow. Yeah, no, it doesn't look like anything. Okay. And I think we missed our bus, so I'm gonna have to now wait until... that's gonna be tight. I'm gonna have to wait until 10. I think as long as we're back by 11, it's fine. So we should have enough time to get home. It's pretty cute. Sanic. Looks like Tama. Bus, let's get out of here. So, if everything goes well, then tomorrow should be a different warehouse that I have to deliver to. So let's hope that's the case. And I have not much time to get home at the moment, so let's haul ass so I don't get in trouble. I know. I'm going. No, wrong room. There we go. All right, let's save. And then, fingers crossed that we're no longer delivering to warehouse number 3. I think it's probably going to be a new warehouse if we did everything correctly, so... I'm not confident enough to pick these turns in first person. These turns are too tight. Sounds like someone hasn't played enough racing games. It's a good point. I definitely haven't played enough racing games.
Pretty damn good for a rookie. Here's your first place prize.
Thanks.
Hope you work as well as you race.
Alright, let's see where we're delivering to. If it's warehouse number 3, I'm gonna scream.
I'm ready.
Take this cargo to warehouse number 18.
There we go.
Here's the route map. Today's quote is written on the map.
No problem.
Okay, get to it then.
Okay, so warehouse 18. And I think I know where we are already, so I don't really need to look at the map. Spent so much time in this harbor now, it's like... I know this harbor like the back of my hand. But I will make sure to do both both paths, because if I don't, I mean, who knows if I'm going to be missing stuff, so. You know, it makes me wonder if Ryo is the highest paid... I'm assuming they meant, like, highest paid, like, forklift driver. After, like, 1 week. And some of these guys... I mean, I'm sure some of these guys have been here for, like, a long time. How much are they slacking off to not have, like, the same salary as Ryo? I mean, you get a raise... pretty much every day, as long as you just do, like, the bare minimum. Whoops. Completely past the warehouse. There we go. This warehouse is much easier to deliver to, because you get a lot more wiggle room. What's my quota? Oh, it's still only 8 crates. Okay. And what's the path it's suggesting? Okay, that's fine. I feel like as long as you follow the path that's on the paper, then you have a chance to trigger something, so... My god, there's everything. A regular, like a business worker, a security guard, a cat, and a forklift all in my way at the same time. There's actually quite a lot of crates here. I'm surprised the quota is only 8. Oh, Draco, hey, welcome in. I forgot to mention, Draco, thank you for reminding me. Guys, I added some new sound alerts. I added a whole bunch of new ones. I meant to mention at the beginning of the stream, I left myself a note where I was like, mention the new sound rewards, and I completely still didn't do it. Yes, I added some new sound rewards. I changed the cost of some of them. And there's a bunch of new ones from like... Devil May Cry and stuff, so yeah, have fun with those. That was one of the new ones, actually. That's Earthworm Jim.
Now I'm a little motivated.
Okay, so nothing happened yet. Thank you for adding this, no problem. I do listen. Okay, we did get a cutscene. Yeah. Oh, what?
Let me take a picture of you two.
No, that's okay.
Don't be shy. Stand there. Here we go. Both of you get in closer. Smile.
Where did Nozomi even come from?
That's it. Here goes. Which do you want? Yo?
Oh, we get to pick which one we want? Well, I mean, we should let her keep the nice one, right? But I kind of want the one on the right. I'm going to be selfish.
Oh, this one.
He okay, looks more pissed than the second
yours,
one.
And this one's Nozomi's. They're keepsakes.
What's with her?
I'm going to Canada.
What?
I took a while to decide, but...
Hey, if it's what you've decided, it's what you've decided.
Ryo, don't do anything stupid.
Of course I won't.
I'll always treasure this. Ryo, take care of yours too.
I will.
I'll come back when I'm on vacation.
Sure.
Bye then, Ryo.
Nozomi.
My guy, you're already doing something astronomically stupid. It's so true. Okay, hold on a second. I have some thoughts. First of all, why was she at the harbor? Second of all, could this man, again, I know we've talked about this, could he be any more robotic? I'm pretty sure he frowned during, like, the photo, and then smiled afterwards. It's almost like his, like,
Mark, have his you face seen is any broken. Of the Mad Angels?
No, sure haven't.
All right.
Or he just, like, he has, like, a slow response in terms of
Hitoshi.
How he shows his emotions.
Is your lunch big enough for you?
Yeah, it's plenty.
You can have half of mine if you want.
Thanks, but
oh, that's nice.
I got a small appetite, so sometimes I can't finish it, you know?
Is that so? Excuse me.
Yeah?
Have you seen the Mad Angels around?
I don't know anything about them. Ask the foreman.
Yes.
Hey, Tsuyoshi.
Hey, Ryo. Are you hiding something from me, man?
No.
You kind of got that look, you know, like you're hiding something.
Well, I'm not.
Really? You sure? Well, you be sure to let me know if something's up.
Yeah.
That man is greatly overestimating our friendship. Okay, so we're gonna head to the cafeteria, maybe? I mean, they did say something about speaking to the foreman.
Hisakusa.
Ryo.
Have you ever seen any of the Mad Angels?
Mad? Well, I don't think I've ever seen them. Sorry, I have no idea.
I see.
Yeah. No, I feel bad for Nozomi, though, because you can tell, like, she cares about Ryo so much, and he's just so emotionless, I guess, is the best word for it. Dense? Yeah. Here, let's go to the cafeteria real quick. We'll see what's going on here. Oh, these guys are...
Excuse me.
What do you want?
Oh, yeah, this is that rude guy.
About the Mad Angels?
Now how am I supposed to know about stuff like that? Give me a break. You be careful, kid. Those gangs gather around here at night.
I see.
Okay, well, give me some information. Alright, well, there's the foreman. Speak to him and see if he's got anything to say.
Hello, Yara-san.
Hey there, kid.
It's Dio.
Yeah, I know. You getting the hang of things?
Yeah, I'm catching on.
That's good. Keep up the good work, kid.
It's Dio.
Yeah, I know.
Okay, well, that wasn't too helpful, but it's okay. Let's continue. I think probably tonight something will happen. I think we just tried it like a day too early. Even though he said tonight, I think we needed to wait an extra day. Okay, and I don't think there's anything else going on here. I can try going over to Warehouse 17 is, just to see if anything else happens. Okay, not really. So you know what, guys? Just give me a moment. Just gonna pause the game and go use the washroom, and I'll be right back. Alright, sorry about that. So let's continue on. So I'm going to assume there's nothing left to do until we're either back at work or afterwards. Something's going to happen at night. So let's hope something triggers. I guess we'll see. Talk to this random guy.
Sorry, but I'm working now. Can't chat with you, kid. Don't need my supervisor bitching at me.
Sure.
That man 100% sounded like Big the Cat. He could be wearing a Big the Cat suit, and I would 100% believe that that is Big the Cat. Anywho, back to work we go. No, you weren't the only one that heard it.
It's already this late.
Okay, let's continue with the crates.
Was it number 18?
Sure was, Ryo. Oh, jeez. Alright, so we're gonna be stacking these ones. Oh, I shouldn't have gone this way. Joggers in my way. There we go. Hmm. Okay, so it's 3 o'clock. If today is going to be like yesterday, then maybe something will trigger sometime after 3:30. We got 11 crates stacked.
Mwah.
Alright, so the day's almost over. Nothing triggered. Oops. nothing triggered during the work day. So I assume that's just because I have to be here in front of the cafeteria at night, and then we'll get a cutscene. I hope. I guess we'll see. Gonna make a pretty good amount of cash today, though. 600 per crate, and how many do we put down? 5, 12, I think 14, 13, 15, maybe 16, 15 or 16 crates? I don't think I'm gonna make it back in time to put this one down, so. Oh god. Oh, you know what? I might have made it back had I not crashed into things. Oh, maybe? Come on. Oh no! So close.
Finished for the day.
Okay, good job. Here's today's pay.
Thank you.
Keep up the good work.
Yes, thank you very much.
No more raise? I guess once you're the highest paid forklift driver, they don't give you any more money. Okay, so then we don't need to do anything else, I think. Until nighttime. At least I hope that's the case. I'll take a quick look-see anyway, and we'll see.
Excuse me.
Eh? What is it, youngin?
Do you happen to know where the Mad Angels hang out?
Why are you looking for them? I hear you.
I really need to. About the local. If you know.
Alright, already.
Here?
They always gather.
At night. I understand.
Don't go.
Okay, so he's still saying to come back here at night. So I'll do just a quick. Once over, and then I guess we'll pretty much just hang out until 7, and then hope that a cutscene triggers. Start talking to Mark.
Mark, have you seen any of the Mad Angels?
No, sure haven't.
Alright. But, Mark.
I'm warning you. You best stay away from them.
Yes?
Have you ever seen any of the Mad Angels?
The Mad Angels? I've never seen them. I heard that they gather over near the harbor cafeteria at night.
I see.
Okay, so yeah. Pretty... You're right? Yeah. It's pretty clear, hopefully, where I have to go. So, in that case, let's, I guess, just chill until 7 o'clock. And, yeah, I'll save again at 6:30. Because that, just in case something goes horribly wrong, and we end up, getting killed or our asses kicked or something, we'll have a closer save file.
Hisakasa.
Ryo.
Have you ever seen any of the Mad Angels?
Mad? Well, I don't think I've ever seen them. Sorry, I have no idea.
I see. Excuse me.
What is it?
Have you ever seen any members of the Mad Angels?
The Mad... I don't know anything about them.
Is that so? Do you know anyone who might know about them?
I can't think of anyone.
Is that so?
I like how Ryo sounds like he just doesn't believe her. I know you're hiding something.
Tom.
Hi, Ryo.
I've got something to ask you. Do you know where the Mad Angels hang out?
I don't know. Ryo, I heard a rumor that you are going after the Mad Angels.
I've got my reasons. Trust me.
No, man. Do not go and get mixed up with them.
If you know anything about them, please, Tom, you've got to tell me.
Sorry, but I don't know, man.
Really?
I wonder what gave it away that I was looking for the Mad Angels. Alright, so I'll save here. Oops. So that'll give us a good restart point in case something bad happens. It's a little creepy the way the sky moves. I never noticed that. When you look around, the sky just kind of like goes back and forth. I Always stormy looking down there? Yeah, right? Okay, so it's almost 7 o'clock. Hopefully that means that we'll be able to trigger the cutscene. One sec, getting snack? No problem. Alright, let's make our way back to the cafeteria. There we go.
Long time no see.
Oh, it's that guy.
This is the guy Charlie. Who's been sniffing around us like a dog?
Looks like we're gonna have to run this stray off now.
I'm gonna get him.
That was a pretty intense QTE sequence.
Smooth move. You ain't so bad, punk.
Why you?
But your time's up.
You wish.
No one takes on the Mad Angels in this harbor and lives to tell about it. It's the bottom of the sea for you. Get him.
Oh. That guy came at me and I just like kicked him and he went flying. That was hilarious. Alright. These guys don't look too tough. It's the camo jacket guy I have to worry about, his buddy. Although this guy's actually taking some hits.
You little brat, I'm gonna break your face. Come on!
Oh, damn. Hey Chris, welcome back. You missed a really good QTE sequence. Where I kicked a couple guys off their motorcycles. Okay, this guy's actually... I'm gonna have to be careful. Is that it? Alright, there we go. Woo!
How are the Mad angels and Chiyu Ming connected?
I don't know.
What?
Wait! I don't know if he's Chiyu Ming, but there's some Chinese big shot leaving here soon.
Big shot?
Yeah, they had me arrange a cruiser to take him out to a big ship offshore.
What's his name?
I don't know, but I hear he wears some silk robe thing with a dragon on it.
Lan Di, he's still around here.
Please, I beg you, don't tell anyone I told you. They'll kill me!
Oh, so we're just gonna tell everyone then. So this guy named Charlie told me there's a guy with a silk robe works for the Chinese cartel. Oh my gosh. Okay, so I think that's probably all we have to do tonight. Because that was actually pretty intense. So we can probably head back now. Before we leave, since the bus isn't going to be here yet, I'll speak to the old guy. I'll see if he has anything else to say. He seems to give pretty good information, pretty good tips.
Excuse me.
Eh? What is it, youngin?
About the Mad Angels?
I heard a rumor that you're still looking for them.
Yes, I am. I heard that they are planning some deal. Do you know about it?
The deal? I did hear something about some large-scale deal happening soon.
Have you heard anything else?
Well, I don't know none of the details.
All right.
Okay. So we didn't get anything from that, but I think Grison might know something, so... I'm not going to call him now. I'll call him tomorrow during our lunch break. I'll call Guizong and go and speak to him. I have a feeling he'll be able to give us some information, so...
Goro.
What's grooving, bro?
What's up?
On patrol, brother! Patrol! Seeing if those nasty bad thugs making trouble in harbor are around!
You seem especially happy.
Speak for yourself! How's work coming?
I'm managing.
Hang in there, bro!
Sure, thanks.
I'm sorry, but what is Goro meant to do exactly? I mean, he wouldn't even give me information because he was terrified of these guys. And yet he's... he's on patrol? And also, where the heck is the bus? Why did it not come at 9 o'clock? I guess we have to wait till 9:30 now. Alright, let's look at our... I'm gonna have to change the batteries in this thing at some point, right? Oh, there we go. There's the bus. Running a little late today.
What's up, Eddie? Eddie, what's up?
There's something wrong with Nozomi.
Something wrong?
Yeah. She's at Sakuragaoka Park right now, but she seemed really down, so Can you go and talk to her?
Yeah.
Don't sound so enthusiastic about it. Okay, so she's at Sekiragaroka Park, which is right up here, I believe. And we'll go and talk to her and see how she's doing. Aww.
Nozomi?
Oh, Ryo.
What's wrong?
Nothing.
Are you crying?
No, I'm so embarrassed.
Problem with your mom?
Yes, she'll stay here, but she says I have to go there.
I see.
It's her family home. She's worried about Grandma, so she's staying.
You don't want to be with your father?
It's not that. I don't want to be away from you. Please. Just for a while. Stay with me. Christmas is already over.
Yeah.
We didn't get to celebrate together.
Yeah.
I'd so wanted to spend Christmas Eve with you.
Nozomi?
Stay with me. For a while.
Yeah.
I wish time would just stand still.
Oh, Ryo. I can't help but just chuckle and just shake my head. Yeah. Yeah. Also, I wonder if in that case, if I'd had that scene before, like around Christmas Eve, if that would have changed things a little bit. I ended up wasting a lot of time, right? Because I couldn't figure out how to progress the story. So, when you got so much going for you, if you just stay put. But no, your monkey brain be revenge. I know, that's the thing. He's actually got like a really nice life, right? And he does. Like, he has a lot going for him. Oh. That was ominous. But yeah, I do wonder if, like, if we had that cutscene around, like, Christmas Eve. She cried, but I couldn't comfort her. Nozomi, please don't leave without saying goodbye. Like, why? Why wouldn't you say that to her? You know what I mean? Anyway. Plan B.
Good morning, everyone.
Go to Canada with her and take the mirror with you. That's actually a really good idea.
You all do your best now.
Yeah!
Like always, three laps to the finish. Everybody ready?
Yeah!
On your mark, almost time to go. Ready? Go!
All right. I feel like we're reaching the end. I know there's some pretty intense stuff coming up, so... we're definitely in the home stretch. Let's try to make this turn in first person. See how it goes. Oh! Oh, I did it!
Pretty damn good for a rookie. Here's your first place prize.
Thanks.
Hope you work as well as you race.
I mean, if Ryo hasn't proven himself by now...
Gotcha. Take this cargo to warehouse number 18. Here's the map. The quota's written on it.
No problem.
This one's a bit further, so don't get lost.
Alright, so warehouse 18 again, but this time it's a different set of crates. He did say warehouse 18, but it's okay because it's a different starting point than it was yesterday, so... Me too, at first I was like, oh god. Also, isn't that where the Mad Angels are? The Mad Angels are at Warehouse 17, if I remember correctly. They're behind Warehouse 17. Which, funny enough, is at the complete opposite end of the harbor. Oh god. Ah! So we'll do the usual, we'll take both paths and see if anything happens, if anything changes. I've only got about another half hour before I'm going to be heading down for dinner. So depending on what happens on this day, we might not actually finish the whole thing. Because I do know there's like a pretty big scene coming up, and if it starts like on this day, I don't think I'm going to have time to finish it. So what I'll do... Oh, did we pass where we're meant to go? I think we did, yeah. So what I'll do in that case is... I'll save, like, in the evening. And then if it turns out that, like, something big happens, I'll end it there, and then we'll continue on Wednesday from that point. My way. Biff. Yeah, this warehouse is like pretty darn far away. What's the quota? The quota's still 8 today. It's pretty crazy. Okay, you know what, guys? I'm really sorry. Just give me a moment. I'm just gonna use the washroom. I'll be right back. All right, sorry about that, guys. I might have just enough time to get this to the warehouse. Let's see. Nobody gets in my way. Oh god. I don't think I'm gonna be that lucky. Come on. Yay, okay, good. Yeah, it took half a day just to put 5 crates down. It's pretty crazy. Alright, so now we'll check around again.
Lunchtime, eh? Mark.
Hey, Dill.
What's up?
Hey, man. You got a girl?
Huh? I don't really have time for stuff like that.
Well, you at least got your eye on someone, right?
Mark, I'm...
Dill, I don't know what you plan on getting out of life, but I'll tell you, it sure is a great thing to have yourself a woman.
Mark. Mark.
You should go on a date once in a while.
I know what you're getting at, but... I wouldn't want someone important to me to get involved in my problems.
Dill, you're a...
you're a... Mark. Mark. Okay, let's, I was gonna call, Guizong and see if, anything's going on. I'm just gonna talk to, like, the three, like, basically most important people and we'll see
Tom.
If they have anything to say.
Hi, Dill!
I want to ask you about the Mad Angels. Do you know anything about some deal they're making?
No, man. The Mad Angels are very dangerous.
I need to find out about them no matter what.
Does it have something to do with your father?
Sure. If you know anything about that deal they're making, tell me.
Sorry, I have no idea. I swear, man.
I see.
All right, so... No help from him, and I think we already spoke to the old guy. He didn't really have anything else to say.
Excuse me.
Eh? What is it, youngin?
About the Mad Angels?
I heard a rumor that you're still looking for them.
Yes, I am. I heard that they are planning some deal. Do you know about it?
The deal? I did hear something about some large-scale deal happening soon.
Have you heard anything else?
Well, I don't know none of the details.
All right.
Okay, so yeah, we'll speak to Guizong. I'll give him a call. We'll head over to the warehouse.
Hello?
Mother's Earth.
Comrades.
Father's Heaven.
9 Dragons.
Warehouse number 8.
Master Chen, please.
Excuse me, but you are...
My name is Hazuki.
Just a moment. What is it?
Yeah. I must consult Master Chen. Arrange us a meeting.
Father's not around.
Well, could you meet me? I need to talk.
Tell me if you must.
Alright. So we'll speak to Guizong. if he doesn't have any information, then I'll run over to Warehouse 17 and we'll see if something triggers. If I have time.
I need to go to warehouse number 8. I have an appointment with Master Chen.
What's your name?
Dio Hazuki.
I've been expecting you, sir. Please, go on in.
The music in here is so so ominous, like something's gonna happen.
Guizan.
Hazuki.
When's that deal with the Mad Angels going down?
What?
Tell me, when is it going to happen?
That's something I can't tell you.
Guizan!
Get lost. Go home.
Guizan, when's the deal going down?
Enough! I have nothing else to say to you.
Okay. So then, yeah, we'll, I'll try to make a run for it. We'll see if we can make it down to the... Oh, this is gonna be... Yeah, I thought so. we'll try to make it down to the warehouse and see if anything happens. Pretty hilarious that Ryo can outrun the forklift drivers. No wonder he's the best worker, right? It's true. Okay, so, yeah, I don't think there's anything else, going on. We'll probably just, finish the workday. I think what I'll do then, so we'll finish the workday, I'll save, and then from there, we'll continue on Wednesday, and, see what happens. Because I have a feeling something's probably gonna happen tonight. I know something's coming up, I'm just kind of waiting for when it's gonna happen. I do remember a specific scene that I think is coming up pretty soon, so...
Back to work. Was it number 18?
Gosh! has my... Here we go. Oh, cutscene. Oh no, it's Goro.
Oh man.
Goro, what happened?
I was just walking with that sailor guy. He... Hey, schoolboy, come on.
You.
Oh, bro. Hey, over here.
Wait.
He's coming?
Whew. Whew. Ha ha, I took the bait!
This guy was not subtle at all.
So you showed, eh? You guys again. What's your problem? Let it be you! Ah! No escape, boy!
Ooh. That elbow to the face he did was actually amazing. Okay, but he folded your asses last time and there were more of you, right?
You're gonna pay for beating up Goro.
You his girlfriend?
What did you say?
Best watch your back. Next time it won't be just you.
What?
We're gonna go after your family and friends! Gonna get them!
That's it! Oh!
Well, at least they told him what they were gonna do. And it's kind of funny how he just goes straight back to work and doesn't immediately... Like, if that were me, okay? I would immediately be calling home and be calling all of my friends and being like... Y'all should watch your backs. exactly, like, I'm on my way home, you guys need to, like, pack up immediately, something's about to go down, right? And instead he's just like, well, you know, I haven't hit quota yet. Oh man, that's too funny. That was a really cool scene, though. I like that. And, okay, is it just me or that sailor guy that, like, you know, quote-unquote baited us? His upper torso seems way too big for the rest of his body. Is it just me? It just seems like there's something kind of weird going on there. I feel like he skipped leg day. Okay, I'm glad it's not just me. Maybe that's why he was out of breath after running around two corners. Yeah. Oh, man. Okay, so we'll finish up the rest of this day. And then I'm going to save. And we'll call it quits. And we'll come back to this Wednesday afternoon. Again, I think we're pretty close to the end, which is pretty cool. I feel like I remember there being one. Oh my god, I'm literally sandwiched. I can't move. I feel like I remember there being one QTE at some point where I think someone's carrying like a weapon, and if you screw it up, it's not like one of those QTEs where like they hit you and then you get another chance, right, to protect yourself. I feel like there's one where if they hit you, you die like immediately and you have to redo the whole thing. I can't quite remember if it's this game or Shenmue 2, but there's definitely at some point, I think, a QTE. Might have been two, yeah, it might have been two. I feel like it's like someone's carrying a knife or something, and if you screw it up, like that's it. Yeah, I find it hilarious. He has so much time between that guy threatening his friends and family and and like the end of the workday. Like, you have so much time to do something about it. Okay, so let's put this over here. Maybe he just has a lot of misplaced faith in Fuxan. That's true. I don't know. I don't think Fuxan could protect the family, but I could be wrong. Maybe he's got some kind of like hidden power that we don't know about. I mean, he seems to be like Ine-san's little, you know, he seems to be kind of like obsessed with like making her happy, so maybe if someone hurt Ine-san, it would like unlock something in Fuxan and he'd just wreck everybody. Alright, so this is going to be the last crate, and at the end of this I will save, and we'll continue Wednesday afternoon, where, like I said, I don't think we have a lot left, so Wednesday, I don't know, Wednesday might be it, depending on how much we get done. If not, then I feel like we have like maybe one more after that. Ultra Instinct Fuxan. Okay, so that's the end of the workday. Let's just wait for the thing to go off.
finished for the day.
Alright.
Okay, good job. Here's today's pay.
Thank you.
Keep up the good work.
Yes, thank you very much.
I have so much money now. Oh, we got another scene.
Hey, Dio. I overheard some information.
Information?
I heard them all whispering something about Long Ja. That is soon.
Long Ja?
Best I can figure, it's some Mad Angel's black market deal. Makes sense. They've been on edge lately.
Long Ja. When's it supposed to happen?
Okay, so we're going to be looking into Long Ja. Alright, so let's save here. I always press the wrong button. And I will come back to this later. We'll see what we can get done. So thank you very much, guys, again, for being here. Chris, Yui, Nerdraco was here. Thank you very much. I'll be back in a couple hours. Tonight is going to be Anno Mutationem again. I hope to see you guys there. But yeah, I hope you guys have a good afternoon. Have a good dinner if you guys are eating around the same time as me. Long Ja, closely connected to the Syndicate. Been chilling. Well, yeah, we'll continue with Anno Mutationem tonight. I think that's going to be a lot of fun. We're making some pretty good progress in that too. And yeah, again, thank you guys so much. And yeah, I'll see you then, okay? Take care.